Hi everyone, this video is about citrus black spot. I will be walking you through the life cycle of citrus black spot briefly with the help of some interesting characters. Citrus black spot is a fungal disease which is caused by Guignardia citricarpa and Ascomycota. Almost all the commercial citrus cultivars are susceptible to this disease. It's fairly new to Florida. It was found in 2010 near Immokalee area and is a very devastating disease in humid subtropical citrus producing countries like Australia, South Africa, Brazil, China, and so on. Let us start the life cycle from the winter season when the sun is sad and most days are gloomy and cold. That's the fire and people are warming themselves up around the fire. That's normally not the case in Florida, but you know. And that's supposed to be a citrus tree. And in the winter season, trees shed leaves and there are dead leaves all around on the orchard floor. And the overwintering ascostroma from the previous season starts producing ascospores. In the case of citrus black spot, it's Pseudotasia. And in the Florida spring, there are alternate wetting and drying period. That's what I'm trying to show with the bright sun and the rain. And that's ascospores. These alternate drying and wetting period is favorable for the ascospore formation and ejection, and it's all out from the Pseudotasia and ready to take over and cause disease to the citrus. And here I'm trying to show the dispersal mode of ascospores. They travel through wind. That's traveling through air. So ascospores normally don't do that, and that's an airplane, but it's more like UFO. And here's another mode of dispersal, waterborne ascospores. I'm trying to make a boat and they're traveling through water, if that makes sense. And there's all 8 ascospores in there, loaded in a boat. And after they travel, land on the leaves and fruits which are susceptible for infection, and it's all excited to cause disease. And here is a Mr. Citrus, all grumpy and proud and very content to himself, and there is ascospores teasing him and trying to cause disease. But the citrus is just like, show off you little ascospore. Arr. And then boom, ascospore disappears. There's no ascospores there, and it's all smug and grumpy and trying to brag about his strength. He's like, totally, I'll teach him. Chase that little ascospore. And there's Miss Citrus, who is all impressed and going gaga over Mr. Citrus, and she's like, oh, you are so strong and brave, I'm impressed. But little did they know that symptoms are not visible right away. The infection remains latent for a few months until the fruit matures. And when the fruit matures, lesions form and it produces pycnidia and conidia, the lesions. And there's the pop of the lesion, and Mr. Citrus is like, oh, what is this? Miss Citrus is all scared and, oh, what? Where? What are you talking about? And the lesions starts forming, and the citrus is diseased. It's finally sick, and it's like, oh, I'm sick now. I'm all covered in lesions. And Miss Citrus is like, oh no, I have to leave you. I don't want to get disease. After the fruit lesions mature, pycnidia are produced, and later oozes of conidia comes out. During rainfall or irrigation, these oozes are washed out by the water. Here is the cartoon version of the splash process. Different expressions of the conidia are shown here, and then these conidia are carried to the nearby fruits and leaves on the water droplets and causes disease. Meanwhile, there is conidia and spermatia formation in the lesions, in the fruit lesions, And here I'm trying to give Colidia a character that's mean all by itself, and that's Promethea, all cute, and there we go. That's a cute Promethea, and here's the conversation. Hi, I'm Colidia, and you?
Hello, I'm Promethea. Nice to meet you.
And Colidia's like, whatever, what do you do?
I'm supposed to be a reproductive structure, but I don't know exactly what I do. And it starts crying,
and Colidia is all mean to him, and it's laughing off. Hee hee hee, you don't know what you do? And Promethea says, what do you do? Colidia is like, I am the second ranunculum of Cebes. I cause Cebes at shorter distances. Wanna see how I cause citrus black spot? And Promethea is all excited and says, yes, I wanna see. And here we go. The Colidia starts germinating. That's the germ tube that's popping out on the side of the stample. And it's later developed to epirosoria. And all the cell content of Conidia, that's the lipid-like structure, moved to epirosoria, and after a while, here's the epirosoria, and it's like, phew, traveling is fun from Conidia to epirosoria. And I'm trying to, after a few hours or a day, the epirosoria starts melanizing, and that's what I'm trying to show here, dark brown in color. It's the melanized epirosoria ready to infect the fruits in surrounding canopies. And these fruit and leaf lesions act as a reservoir for the next season infection, but leaf lesions normally don't show up quickly. They appear in the fruit litter, leaf litter later. So life cycle repeats as long as the conditions are favorable, and we should keep fighting because plants need us. And thank you for watching. Hope you learned something from this video, and thank you again.